morning, everyone. This is Elaine from Annabella's. Welcome back to FlossTube 174. I am very happy that you're here today. If you're new to my channel, this channel is primarily about cross stitching, quilting, and paper crafting with a little bit of my life thrown in every now and then. And if you're returning, as always, thank you so much for coming back, spending some time with me on Friday mornings. I appreciate all of you so much. As does Terry and our entire family. So thank you for being here. If you haven't subscribed, please look up. Go ahead and subscribe, ring that notification bell. That will just let you know when I've uploaded a new video or I have some fun news to share. And if you are new, let me tell you what our philosophy is here at Annabella's. And that is, we believe in being perfectly imperfect. And what I mean by that is, if you make a mistake when you're quilting or cross stitching or paper crafting, it is perfectly okay. Just push on through, finish your project off. It's very likely no one's going to know the mistake is there except you. So enjoy the journey, whatever your favorite craft might be. So I don't have much of a life update today. I've been busy getting ready for Needlework Marketplace and catching up on all of the work that I missed when I was under the weather, but I'm feeling 100% better, and it is very good to be back in the shop with all of my team and, you know, helping Terry, who, you know, kind of ran the shop there for about 3 weeks. So anyway, today's going to be a longer video than normal, and that's because I left my video tripod in Waco, so I couldn't do QuiltTube yesterday. So what we're going to do today, if you can bear with me, is I'm going to do all the cross stitch first, and then at the end of the video, I'm standing today, I'm going to be exhausted later, and then what I'm going to do at the end of the video is I'm going to go ahead and do the QuiltTube, okay? So just bear with me if you don't mind. First, what we're going to do is I'm going to have a sip of water because I still have a dry throat every now and then. So first, what we're going to do is I'm going to share with you a new release by Annabella's Needle Art. Now, this is the full reveal of our new cross-stitch booklet called It's Finally Fall. And this will be coming out at Needlework Marketplace in the next couple of weeks for shops that want to purchase it. But for all of you, you can go ahead and place your pre-order for it later today. So there are 7 different designs in this beautiful booklet. It's our first large autumn themed cross-stitch booklet. So my daughter and I are thrilled and hope that you love it and that you'll enjoy stitching all of these items. Now, what's really fun, because you know, we always do things a little bit differently here at Annabella's. The booklet is available in printed format, okay? So that's the only way that the booklet comes. So you have to purchase the booklet if you want to receive all 7 charts. But what I decided to do, because I know some of you may not want all 7 charts, is all of the charts will also be available individually as PDFs only in the Etsy shop, okay? And other shops won't have those. You'll only be able to get the PDFs at Annabella's. So let me show you everything that's in the booklet. I'm happy to share with you the Simple Sampler Autumn. So here is the beautiful Simple Sampler Autumn. It's just gorgeous. This was finished by Wanda Burgess. She did all my finishing for me on this booklet, as she has been really picking it up for me and helping me tremendously here as we get busier and busier. But just look how pretty that is. What a fun sampler. I love the colors. I just really enjoyed this. So that's the first one. Next, we have another one that I really, really love. This is called And All at Once. And it's a quote by Oscar Wilde, if those of you that are familiar with him. And it says, "And all at once, summer collapsed into fall." And I just really love that quote. We turned this into a little pillow. Wanda finished it off on the back. This is just some fabric we have in the shop. You've got your raven, you've got your little saltbox house, a little squirrel. Just a really fun quote that you can turn into a pillow like we did, or certainly frame it if you'd like, and finish it any way that you would like. But this is included as well. Then this is probably my favorite. As you know, we do a lot of baskets, and this is our autumn basket. Actually, I think I'm calling him, am I calling him autumn? I'm either calling him autumn or Halloween in the booklet. This is finished off on one of our Bella boards, okay? And you can also hang it if you so choose, or you can put it on a tear tray. So that is also in the booklet. That's the third chart. Or the fourth chart. This is our little autumn alphabet. And want to just attach one of our barn stars. As you know, we use a lot of these primitive doodads, if you will, in our finishes. That's pretty, I love the little button there. So that's our autumn alphabet. Then we have our tiny little autumn quilt. The yellow is not coming across very well on here, but isn't that cute? Just real tiny, great to put in a dough bowl, or again, stick in a tiered tray. I know I have this glare. The only way to get rid of this blue glare is to take my glasses off and then I won't be able to see, so I can't do that. Just gotta live with the blue glare. There you go. Then Welcome Fall is finished on one of our Bella boards. Isn't that pretty? Love this ribbon. I love the cording around that. You're gonna be seeing more cording from us, hopefully available in the shop for you to purchase. There you go. And then last in the booklet is our pumpkin patch. Let me just fix this bow real quick. Here's pumpkin patch. Isn't that neat? And this was stitched by Wanda as well. Just love all the different pumpkins and the squirrels and the scarecrow. Not so scary scarecrow. So there you go, you guys. First reveal of the charts coming to Needlework Marketplace. And like I said, you can pre-order your chart today. You can wait until your favorite shop has it, or you can also get the PDFs individually if you don't want to buy the booklet. So there you go. Okay, now I have two baskets of things to show you of new items that have come into the shop, all cross-stitched. So I'm going to go through all that first, and then when we're done with that, I'm going to tell you about a new designer that we just brought into the shop. So you might want to grab a piece of paper and a pencil. You might see something here that you like. Actually, I have two new designers we've just brought into the shop. So let me start with the first one. Brenda Keys is also known as the Sampler Company. That's her company. Brenda does a lot of cross-stitch samplers, and they are just beautiful. She also does a very popular book called Ultimate Sampler Motifs. This booklet is now available at Annabella's. It is filled with all kinds of little motifs. If you would like to stitch something on your own and, you know, maybe even make your own cross stitch chart, you know, you can certainly find something in this booklet to stitch. So I thought that was really cute. So this is now available. And then here are her samplers that we brought in. The first one is called The Tall Ships. Isn't that pretty? And this is 16 by 16 approximately when stitched on 36 count. I can't take these out of the sleeves. They're tightly sealed. This one is Abigail Markham Sampler. I just love these colors. This is a beautiful sampler if you're thinking of autumn themed colors to stitch for, or sampler to stitch for autumn. In this colorway, it's just stunning. This is 15 by 12 and a half when stitched on 25 count. She used natural Dublin linen. Here we have Every Heart Sampler, and this is 11 by 11 stitched on 25 count Lugana. Okay. What's really fun is on the back, in the back, she also includes thread organizer, and she includes this little card so that you can keep track of when you stitched it and what year you stitched it in. And then she includes a thread organizer for your threads. And then there's a separate sheet here that tells you all the floss requirements and fabric requirements. And that's on all of her charts. Another sip of water. Next is Plenty and Grace Sampler. This finishes off at 12 and a half by 9 3/4, stitched on 18 count cream devasa. Beautiful sampler. Here is Red Sampler House. Everybody loves a good Red Sampler House. Oh, that's pretty. And that is about, she stitched that on 18 count rustico. It's about 15 and a half by 13 inches. Okay, next is red marking sampler. Isn't that beautiful? Love red work. 7.5 by 9.75, stitched on 32 count Belfast linen in white. Looks like antique white, but it's actually white. Next we have, by Brenda, And All the Blackbirds Singing. All the Blackbirds Singing. And this is 13.75 by 12 on 28 count natural linen over 2. And this is considered a beginner sampler. So if you haven't stitched a sampler before, or you've been intimidated by doing a sampler, this might be a good one to start with. There's only 8 or 9 called for colors. It's all DMC. It's not very large, and you can stitch it on 28 count or 14 count. So think about that if you are thinking about a sampler. And again, it's called And All the Blackbirds Singing. Here's another one that's beginner friendly. This is the Blue House sampler. So this is a little smaller. This is about 7.5 by 7.5, 105 by 105 stitch count. Again, she uses both DMC and some Weeks Dye Works in this. And she stitched this on 27 count Linda in vintage mocha. So another great sampler for beginners if you would like to give one a try. And then this is really fun. This is brand new. She just released this. This is called Stitches in Red. And it's a collection of all red on white designs for those who love that genre. And inside, let me see how many charts there are. Oh, a lot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. There's 19 charts in the book, plus finishing instructions. So there you go. Think ahead to Christmas. This would make a really nice gift for a stitchy friend. And these are while supplies. Well, I'll order them again. I'm not going to say while supplies last, because as soon as we run out, I'll get more. Okay, now, the rest of the items I'm going to show you, I'm going to insert the photos. So let me jump ahead to some wool applique that came in, and then I'll go back and insert photos and talk to you about all the rest of these. Well, let me do that first. Never mind. I'm so tired. Let me start over. Okay. Let me tell you what has also come in that I don't have here yet, but it's on the way. I'll insert the photos here. The first is the 2024 Just Cross Stitch Christmas Magazine is now available for you to pre-order. This will ship to shops, I believe, in October. And this is the photo of the cover. And I believe there's 50 projects in this issue. So that's really nice. And it's one of the most popular Christmas cross stitch magazines out there. So you might want to take a peek at that. And then I woke up yesterday to 4 amazing new releases by Brenda Gervais with Thy Needle and Thread. And I'm going to insert them here. I'm going to refer you to the Etsy shop if you want information on stitch counts and cross stitch fabric recommendations and floss requirements on each one. The first one is my favorite. This is Autumn Swan. And she's done a couple other swans, and I think it's going to be an ongoing series for her, perhaps. But this is Autumn Swan. I absolutely love this, and I am going to be stitching this. The next one, I love her twist on words. This is Gourdness Gracious. So gourds are popular as we approach fall, and here's Brenda's twist on Gourdness Gracious. Then this adorable little witch is called Woodland Witch. And then last, we have a Feels Like Fall, which is just a beautiful autumn sampler by Brenda. So all 4 of those charts are available to pre-order now. There's only a couple days left. We can take pre-orders, and then we'll be placing our order with Brenda. I think she's going to ship out at the end of August, she said. No, I'm sorry. That's not right. She's shipping out next week. So get your order in if you want these. Okay, next we have Cosette Agogo. We carry their charts quite a bit. I just put in an order for all of their newest releases. Now, all of these ship from Italy. They're on the way. I think they arrive here tomorrow or the next day. So they are, I'm going to insert them here. The first one is Halloween Sampler. Next is Autumn Basket. Love this. Next is be thankful. Then they have Autumn in the City. I love these. She does a few of these. And the next one is Christmas in the City. So you have both Autumn in the City and Christmas in the City. And then last is probably one of my favorites as far as Christmas releases, and that is Believe. And this is not new. I believe this was out last year, I believe. But we didn't have it. We've ran out. So here it is again. So there you go. Now, before I go over to wool applique, let me talk to you about a new designer that is not new to the cross stitch industry, but is new to Annabella's. So I'm always on the lookout for designers that are new to me, meaning that we haven't carried their charts before. And there are just so many designers, you guys. I'd need twice the size building if I carried everybody's charts. But Not Forgotten Farm, her name is Lori. She is the designer of the charts I'm going to show you in just a moment. I fell in love with her designs. As you know, we do some prim and American folk art designing ourselves here at Annabella's. But Lori's charts just absolutely are beautiful. And I wanted to share with you the ones that I like, because if I like them, I'm hoping that maybe you'll like them too, if you do like primitive and folk art cross stitch. So here we go. The first one is Reginald Raven. Now look at how stinking cute this guy is. Isn't he adorable? So a great autumn themed or Halloween themed stitch. And then I guess he's got a girlfriend. Her name is Cornelia Crow. So there you go. You've got Reginald Raven and Cornelia Crow. And then Lori also has teeny Halloweenies. These are so stinking cute. You can stitch these up individually. You can put them in a dough bowl, or you can stitch them all together. Next is The Flight. So she has her broom out. Then we have Halloween Queen. Let me get a sip of water. Here is Witch Hazel. This one, the next two are really, really cute. I love Witch Hazel. And then to go along with Witch Hazel, we segue right into Christmas with her Cinder Claus. So they're cute little stockings. Aren't they adorable? Then this one's fun. It's called Merry Maker. Next one is Good Cheer. I love this one, Merry Old Christmas. Then we have Holly Jolly. And last is Snow Ho Ho. So there you go. Beautiful new designs in the shop by Not Forgotten Farm. We'll be carrying her on a permanent basis. So be sure to check it out. She also has an Etsy shop if you'd like to check that out as well. Okay, now let me go through with you all kinds of wool applique charts that we got in. So we carry a lot of wool charm packs, which I'm going to show you in just a minute. They're 5x5 squares. All the 5x5 squares that we carry in the shop are usually enough for the charts that I'm going to show you right now. One of these designers is new to Annabella's, so I'm going to show you her items first. It's Penny Lane Primitives. So I love her designs. And again, it goes to that, I don't know, vintage, primitive style. All right, so these are all in their packs. So let me show them to you. Let me get the Christmas ones last. Okay, first one is a table mat and a mini mat, and it's called Pumpkin Party. So look at that. Isn't that adorable? Can you see how cute that is? Look at the candy corn. Okay, and now on the back of the chart, we'll list everything that you need to know. Now, when you go to the Etsy shop, if this is the ones that you jotted down you wanna look at, when you go to the Etsy shop, I always include the back of the chart. So you're going to be able to see exactly how much wool felt you need or wool, and exactly what DMC floss you need. Okay, so there you go. This is the first one, and it's called Pumpkin Party. Next is Pretty Pumpkins. And again, this is also a table mat and a mini mat. And these are adorable. These make great hostess gifts if you're going to be doing any type of if you're attending any parties or any events over the autumn and fall season, these would be fun as a hostess gift. Then this one I love, this is called the Pumpkin King. Just look at him. He's sitting on that pumpkin like he owns it. Then we have October Treats. Oh my goodness, they're so cute. Do you have a Halloween tree? I don't. I'm not a big Halloween person anymore, but then I see something like this and I'm like, oh my goodness, I need to stitch those. But what I need to remember, because you know, I don't have enough to do, is that I have grandchildren who would love those. So, okay, next I'm gonna show you her Christmas designs that we have. The first one is a candle mat and a mini mat and ornaments. So here, this is December Magic. Very pretty. There you go. These mini stockings are adorable. You get 8 mini stockings. Then she has tags, so Christmas tags. Again, these are great to attach to a gift that you're giving away. You can also use them as ornaments and hang them on a tree, but these are really fun. Then Stars and Stripes. Then here are mini mittens. I showed you the mini stockings. This is the coordinating mini mittens. Now I've got just a few things to show you from Bare Roots and from Buttermilk Basin. Bare Roots, everything nice ornaments. So these are ornaments. Again, I always include the back when you go to the Etsy shop. If this is something that you like, you can check it out. All the information will be there. These are two of the most popular designs by Bare Roots. We carry them every year. And they go quick. The first one is the little Halloween pillows. They're adorable. Great Dobo fillers, great gifts. And of course, if you do have a Halloween tree or you want to make them ornaments, you can certainly do that. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's 6 Halloween pillows. Naughty and Nice. These are her little Christmas pillows. I'm trying to get the glare off there. Okay. And then Rachel's of Greenfield. I don't know why I didn't get more in. I only got this one little kit. I think it's because they were sold out. This was popular, so I brought it back this year. It's a kit. It's called Warm Hands. So you can make all these mittens. Very easy. Everything is included. All your felt, all your floss. And it makes 6 little ornaments. Little mittens. Okay, another sip. Oh my goodness, it's already been 20 minutes. Okay, but I did warn you, it's gonna be longer today. All right, Buttermilk Basin. This is adorable. This is her Christmas Star Table Runner. It's about 15.5 by 42.5. Great table runner pattern. Fabric requirements are always listed on the back. And they just tell you red, green, cream, black, and how many yards you need. Then this is so cute. These are 3 little snowmen. Look how cute they are. This is absolutely stunning. This is a quilt. It finishes off at 63 by 63. It's so beautiful. I'm taking it out of the bag to show you the photo. Let me get a better picture of it. Just look at that. Isn't that beautiful? Hold on, it's wiggling. Isn't that gorgeous? Now, everything is in here. Oh, is that your big boy voice? Rawr, rawr, rawr. Riley's talking to me. Rawr, rawr, rawr. Okay, so that's my Buttermilk Basin. And it's called Pumpkin Farm. Like I said, 63 by 63. It tells you how much fabric you need. All the instructions are in here and they're very easy to follow. Okay, what else did I do? Is that everything? I thought I had more from Buttermilk Basin, but I guess that's it. Okay, so that is everything right there. And then here is the other basket that I wanted to show you what the wool the wool packs look like. So they come like this. They're 5 by 5 squares, and I believe there's 5, 1, 2, 3. There's 5 squares in each packet. And they're always by colorway. So the yellows, the oranges will be like this. So here is an example. This is called Sunflower. great fall colors. Then we have candy corn. And candy corn is one of the few that has some mixtures. So if you're thinking Halloween or autumn and you want something, you know, as you're creating, that is a little bit different colors, there you go. This would be one I would recommend. Then we have some avocado. Now in the Etsy shop, we have tons, but in the Etsy shop, we have quite a few different greens. So this is just called avocado, but there's other types of greens in there as well. So you can find a green that you like the most. And then this one is prim pumpkin. So you can see some have little prints and some are solids, but they're all great for any type of wool applique that you're doing. So there's that. Then I wanted to show you, I'm trying to separate the seasons here. Okay. I want to show you some of the buttons that we just got in. Now, if you follow our cross-stitch finishing here at Annabella's, you know how much we like to make finishing fun. So part of doing that is when I cross-stitch and have a finish and it's a pillow, I usually, you know, put them right sides together, make a small, you know, cut and turn them inside out and stuff them that way, which means I need a button to put on my wool felt square or my piece of fabric to cover the back. So we always increase our stock here at Annabella's around the holidays. And as they're approaching, these are just an example of four that I got in for Halloween. We have a ton of them, but I couldn't bring them all. I just wanted to show you a few. So these are carved pumpkins. Now, on the back of a lot of these are the shanks. If you have a wire cutter, you can just literally cut this off and then it will lay flat when you adhere it to your pillow or to your back, okay? Is that light flickering or is it me? Oh God, okay. All right, so these are really easy to adhere. And almost all of them have shanks. This is Pumpkin Harvest. These are called Scream. They're just different Halloween buttons. I do use buttons that have holes. I just take a piece of twine or a piece of ribbon and I thread it through the hole, or I use embroidery floss. So you can also use embroidery floss. This one's really cute. This is Farmer's Market. And it's got pumpkins, a scarecrow, some sunflowers. Look how cute that is. So there's that. And then here are some Christmas ones so you get an idea of what's available. These are little gingerbreads. These I love. These are a little bit larger. So this is some presents. It's called, what's it called? I don't know. I think we're just calling it Christmas presents. Then look at these adorable snowmen. Aren't they adorable? They remind me of Frosty. And then this is my favorite. Who has a favorite button? Am I the only one that has a favorite button? This is my favorite. This is holiday baking, and I just love it. There's a little, you know, baking tray that you can see the cookies on, and then there's the gingerbread, there's a rolling pin, and there's some cookies, finished cookies. Just adorable. I don't know if I've ever told you guys this, but I am a dollhouse miniature enthusiast. So this would be great in my dollhouse. So there you go. Okay, so put that aside. And then I guess I can leave that here. Okay, what do I want to show you now? Let me look at my list. Okay, we did that. Okay, before I go on to quilting, which I'm going to talk to you about in just a second, I want to update you on cross stitch, still finish out cross stitch. The Needlework Marketplace is coming up, as I said, August 23rd. So that's going to run Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday. It's long, okay? So what I recommend that you do is either A, you subscribe to our newsletter, so you're going to get all the information when there's new releases, because I remind you to go to the group or to go to the Etsy shop. Or you can join our Annabella's 2024 Needlework Marketplace Facebook group. We have over 1,000 folks that are in the group. It's really fun. You're gonna get to see all of the different designs that are released as soon as the designers release them. Now, I haven't been putting very many sneak peeks because quite frankly, the designers haven't sent out all the full charts yet. So those, like I am, they're slow in coming. But when they're here and we get the final reveals of everything, you will find all of that in the Facebook group. I also do sneak peeks on occasion of Annabella's stuff. Then you can go to Annabella's Etsy shop, and there is a drop down bar, or there's a menu on the left that will say 2024 Needlework Marketplace. That is where all the releases are going to be. So is, and I think there's 60 of them in there now. So whenever a designer does a full reveal and they've sent the information to shops, that's when you'll see it there. So lots of different ways for you to learn about all the designers and all of the items that are coming out. Let me tell you, they are beautiful. Now, Terry doesn't know this yet, but I've made a decision. We're gonna cut off all pre-orders on August 21st, okay. That's Wednesday, and then it starts on the 26th. No, it ends on the 26th, but I'm cutting off pre-orders on the 21st so that I can get my orders in. Now, let me make sure that you hear me when I say this, because it's important. Some designers that are also releasing fabric have cutoff dates much sooner than my cutoff date. I am not going to adhere to that, because I'm not going to be ordering, you know, a lot of fabrics, because much of the fabrics come from overseas and we just have a, you know, hard time getting it. So we are just going to order charts, and I can order from the designers all the way through the event, which ends on Monday at 3. So there's no reason to make you put in a pre-order, you know, that far in advance. I want you to be able to take your time and browse, you know, and give me almost up to the last minute to get your pre-order in, okay? If you have any questions on this, just send me an email, annabellashop@gmail.com, and I will respond quickly. Let me preface something real quick. I don't know if you guys know this, probably you don't, but we closed the shop to local folks on Sundays and Wednesdays. Now, we are always closed on Sunday, and now we've added Wednesdays. We're closed. We need a minute to catch our breath. So when we are in the shop on Wednesday, we do not answer the phone, okay? It's crazy. We were here yesterday. The phone must have rang a dozen times. So we don't answer the phone on Wednesday, because the whole purpose of being closed in the shop is that we can get some work done that we ordinarily won't get done. But we do respond to emails. So feel free to email us on Wednesdays if you cannot reach us, and we'll respond as quickly as we can. Okay. But I just wanted to let you know that. Okay. So now back to the Needlework Marketplace. Your orders will ship as soon as the show ends. The designers start invoicing everybody, and then the designers start packing and then shipping. We can't give you an exact date when your items are gonna ship, particularly if you place multiple pre-orders in your cart and one designer is slower than another to get the items to us. But I promise you, Terry and I and our team work hard to get everything out to you just as fast as we can. And as soon as your last item is here, from the designer you pre-ordered from, that is when your entire order will ship, okay? And always message us through Etsy if it is regarding an Etsy order. Do not message us through emails. Do not email us. You must message us through Etsy. Now, why is she saying that? Why can't I send you an email? Because it's against Etsy policies, okay? Let me take another sip of water. I didn't think I was going to say this, but let me just tell you now. Okay, we're very diligent about making sure that as Etsy sellers, we follow all the rules and we cross the T's and dot the I's. And part of Etsy's seller policies is that you're not emailing your customers outside of Etsy, unless, of course, they've purchased from you outside of Etsy. So when it comes to an Etsy order, you need to message us through Etsy. If you send an email to annabellashop@gmail.com, it's very unlikely that you're going to get a response, okay? First of all, we have no way of tracking it. We'd have to email you back, what's your order number, the whole thing. If you want a quick response, please go to your Etsy order, message us through that. We have 100% positive seller feedback on messages. We answer messages every single day, constantly. But I promise that if you message us on any Etsy order you have, we'll get back to you quickly, okay? Don't email me. Don't email me on that question. Okay. Let's see what else. All right. Okay, we're at Needlework Marketplace. Okay, before we go, I'm going to do quilting last. Well, I guess I'll do it now. Do I want to do it now? Let me see where it is. No, quilting's last, so we got to keep going. Okay. Boxes. Everybody loves a good box. Okay, I got lots of fun things to talk with you about boxes. So if you're new to the channel, Annabella's puts out a number of boxes every month, every year. The first box is fairly new. It's called our 12 monthly minis. Now, these are smaller than our larger mystery boxes. These are mini boxes that include two charts, as well as floss and fabric and some, you know, maybe a couple of other things. Those go out monthly. Now, our August box has shipped. I'm not going to do the reveal today because I checked and a lot of folks that live in California haven't gotten theirs yet. So I'm going to do the August mini box reveal next week. If you want to see some of the things that folks have gotten in their mini boxes, you can look at past videos. September mini box is now sold out. But if you would like to participate in our 12 monthly minis, you can sign up at annabellas.net for the October mini box. The October mini box is going to be Thanksgiving themed. Now, how does it work? So what's really nice about our subscription is that you can join anytime, and every month you're going to get an invoice. And you can, and when Elaine doesn't make a mistake like I did last month, I told everybody that they were getting billed for October and it was for September, so I apologize. I had COVID brain. It took me forever to straighten that out. That's what you get for working when you're sick. Never again. I made a real hodgepodge out of that. But point is that you can go ahead and order the October mini box and then say, you know, you love it and the December invoice comes along, but you don't want the December box. You can just ignore the invoice, or when you get the invoice, say you want to skip the box and we'll just skip it. Then you'll get an invoice every month until you tell us to either A, can't, you know, don't send that box, send the next one, or B, cancel my subscription in totality. We want you to always feel like you can cancel at any time. I don't want you to feel obligated to buy anything you don't want to buy. But I know how many of you love these boxes, so you're going to get invoiced and raise your hand and say, you know what, I'm going to skip August or I'm going to skip January. That's perfectly fine. But then if you've had your fill of boxes because you've got boxes coming out of your ears, you can just say, cancel altogether, I'm done. It's fine. We're happy that you just even take a peek at what we have to offer you. Okay, so 12 monthly minis, sign up. October's coming. Probably the cutest and the best boxes, I would always say, are going to be holiday related. So you've got October, November, December coming along. So feel free to join. You can only join at annabellas.net. Okay, October mini box, like I said, is Thanksgiving themed. And today, our biggest box of the year has gone on sale. This is our Christmas mystery box. Now, we did open up a Save My Box opportunity for folks a week or so ago. That is pretty much cut off. Invoices on the balance will go to everybody on August 15th. So I think today is August 8th. So for now, you know, you can certainly go to annabellas.net and pay the $19.99 and then get billed for the balance when I cut it off on August 15th, or you can just go to Etsy if you're sure you want it without any hesitation and just order it on Etsy. Whatever works best for you. You can either go to Annabella's or go to Etsy. We try to make it easy and flexible for you. The Save My Box is just so that, you know, people don't have to put an outlay every 5 minutes on boxes. So the Christmas box is going to be beautiful. It's all Christmas themed and it is a country Christmas. So I cannot wait. I'm so excited about this box. But all the information, most of every question you can have is there both in the Etsy listing and on Annabella's. And yes, you can email me if you have any questions on that. Okay, let's talk about something else that I haven't talked about in a while, but I want to talk about it today because I'm going to share something with you. Because we're talking boxes, right? What else is new? Let me scoot this over because I got to get the box. Okay, this is a Stitchcation box. Now, what in the world is a Stitchcation? I'm gonna read, because there's a lot. Okay, so when I started Stitchcations, it was that if you have a bunch of friends and you can't attend an in-person retreat, how can you all get together? And I thought, well, you know, if virtual retreats aren't your thing, which we do pop-up retreats and you're not a big fan of those, and you can't get to a virtual retreat or only half of your friends can go and the other half get left behind, I thought, well, how can we bring the concept of a virtual retreat or a pop-up retreat or an in-person retreat to folks where they are? So it's kind of like a staycation, right? You stay at home, you know, you do things around town, you know, you don't leave, but you still take a step back. That's how Stitchcation was born. I want all of you that meet that criteria, that have friends, that, you know, want to sit and stitch and maybe have some fun and play some games and get a box, i.e. like a swag bag in the mail, I want you to be able to do that. So the way the Stitchcations work is it's our way of making sure that you have a day filled with stitching and relaxation and fun. And you can play games and you can do finishing, but it's all from the comfort of your own home. Now, let me say a couple of things. One is, it doesn't matter how many people you have. Maybe you have 3 people. Maybe you have 60 people. Maybe you have 200 people. Whatever you would like is what we will do for you. So you can have it in your own home. Some folks rent a small conference center or go to a place that allows them to have 10, 12 people, whatever works for you. And then I work with you directly, just me, to come up with a box that's going to be something that you envision, whether it's a holiday themed box, whether it's just a designer that you want featured. We will do everything we can to create a box that is gonna be so much fun for your guests to receive and so much fun for you. And we take all of the work out of it. So for example, if you're gonna play our Floss Toss game, which is the same as left, center, right, I just call it Floss Toss. You're gonna get the dies, you're gonna get whatever you need. If you wanna play Bella Bingo, you're gonna get a Bella Bingo card. So let me share with you a little bit about what's in a Stitchcation box. Okay, so the box comes like this. Now all of your guests, the boxes are shipped to them directly, unless you want it to be a mystery Stitchcation box where it's stitched, sent to you individually. We can send them all to you, or we can stitch, or we can send them all directly to your attendees. Okay, so when we get the box, a couple things are gonna be included. First is gonna be a list of everything that's included in the box, okay? So that they're gonna know what they're receiving. This particular box that I'm showing you right now, I'm gonna show you the charts first, and then I'm gonna show you all the extra things that they got. Okay, so this box includes 4 charts, okay? And price points are, boxes are determined by what your price point is, right? So if you wanna have everyone spend $50, or that's what your group agrees to, or that's what you agree to, then that's how we plan it. So don't be overwhelmed by the amount of items that people receive in their boxes. It doesn't have to be this elaborate. It can be whatever you choose. And I will work with you to come up with a Stitchcation that works best for you and your friends. Okay, this particular box received Strawberry Fields Forever. They received, and that's by Blackbird Designs. They received Strawberries and Stripes by Brenda Gervais. They received Shepherd's Pie by Plum Street Samplers. And they received an exclusive chart by Annabella's called Basket of Blooms Strawberries 2. This will be released over the weekend probably. This is Basket of Blooms Strawberries 2. We did a Strawberries earlier and this is number 2. They received a Bella Bingo card, both sides, so they can play Bella Bingo. They received the fabric of their choice. Okay, so, and this is a fat quarter. So everybody received fabric of their choice. They received finishing supplies. This is one of our tart tins, as well as the inserts that we use for mounting. In their strawberry, that's how it's finished. So they receive the finishing supplies to finish that off. They also receive backing fabrics. So there is 3 different fabrics in here. Let me show you. I believe these are fat 8s. So they received a set of, oh, actually there's 4. 1, 2, 3. Oh no, they got 5. I guess I was being generous that day. There you go. So they received all of these beautiful fabrics. They received floss pack, all the Classic Colorworks floss, fancy floss. They got a floss drop. Let me open this up and show it to you. trying to open it up. She sealed it. Oh, here is the strawberry floss drop. Little charm. There's the strawberry floss drop that coordinates with the Annabella's strawberry basket. They received a needle minder, embroidery hoop needle minder. Let me take it out. It's so glary. I hate glare. There you go. Cute little embroidery hoop. Why is this so blurry? There you go. Seam ripper. Elaine loves these. Gotta have a seam ripper. Gotta have a lot of seam rippers. Rip, rip, frog, frog. And they received a project bag, final project bag, with a big strawberry charm. So that's an example of what is included in a Stitchcation box that we customize, as I said, just for you and your friends. Now, like I said, 60, 30, 10, 12, whatever you want, that is what we will do for you. So do not hesitate to go to annabellas.net. You can read all about Stitchcations. If you have any questions, let me know. We also have something that goes on here at Annabella's that is kind of private, but it's called Grab and Go. I'm not going to spend a lot of time on that now. You can read about our Grab and Go events as well. You just grab your friends and you go. Where do you go? You come here to beautiful North Carolina. You spend time here in the shop. The shop is closed. It's for you and your friends. You spend a weekend cross-stitching and shopping and doing all of the things that you love. Plus, we coordinate beautiful places for you to stay, lots of fun outside activities for you to do. And again, that is also customized. So there you go. All right, that was fun. Let's move on to, I love my Stitchcations, retreats. Okay, and then we'll do quilting. Quilting is last. Retreats. All Things Autumn Retreat is with Erica Michaels and Sweet Wings Studio. That retreat is sold out, okay? So the next retreat is the Autumn Pop-Up Retreat, and that is with Emily Call, and registration is still open. We have more flexibility with that than we do with the in-person retreats. So Emily Call is wonderful. You guys love her designs. It would be nice to spend some time with her. Feel free to join us. Go to annabellas.net. You can learn all about it there. You can also register at on the Etsy shop. And that retreat pop-up is September 28th, the day before my birthday. That'll be from 11 to 6 Eastern Standard Time. So again, looking forward to that. Then, our next retreat is our All Things Winter Retreat. That's our next in-person retreat after the fall one. That is going to be held in February 6th, 7th, and 8th in Hilton Head Island. And registration is open right now for that retreat. This is a signature event. I envision this to be a very, kind of like Waco, very laid back, lots of fun, lots of games, little bit of pampering, some great meals, some shopping. Hilton Head Island is just beautiful. We got great rates from the hotel. It is a resort. I had someone get annoyed with me because of a resort fee. Look, you know, resorts are different from staying at your, you know, basic Holiday Inn. There's going to be some additional fees. And it's $35. But, you know, some of the big resorts do have, you know, fees. We try to offset for you, though, when we do book these events, our signature events at pricier places, we ask them to give us some concessions. And in this particular instance, breakfast is included every day. And we do other things, too, for you. But you can learn all about the Hilton Head Retreat at annabellas.net. We would love to have you. Terry and I will be celebrating our 26th anniversary on February 7th. So he will be there as well. So it's going to be fun. We're going to extend our trip a couple days. And then Little Monster is going to be there too, along with Riley. And I think we're bringing the cat. Oh gosh. Because we're going to make a little anniversary trip out of it as well. So we'd love to see you there. Maybe you can celebrate with us. All right, whew, another sip of water, and then let's talk quilting. So if you're gonna pop out now, love you. Thanks for spending time with me. Oh my gosh, it's been 49 minutes. I will see you next week if you're gonna pop out. And if you're gonna stay, let me get my sip, and we will start looking at some fun quilting things. All right, let me get rid of these boxes, because they're everywhere. All right, what do I want to start with? Let me start with this book. Okay, if you love to quilt, Halloween Memories by Susan Ake is filled with 6 quilts and 9 cross stitch designs. So this book is amazing. It's available now in the Etsy shop. I wanted you to see it. If we sell out, we'll get more, but I'm telling you, it's gorgeous. And again, great idea for a Christmas gift for a cross stitch friend or a quilting friend. So there's that. Then I'm gonna save Lori Holt for a minute. Let me show you this collection that just came in because it is beautiful. This fabric collection is called Georgia. It's by Brenda Riddle. Here is the 10-inch squares. Now we carry all the pre-cuts. So we've got the 10-inch squares, we've got the jelly roll, which is 2.5-inch strips, and we have the charm packs. Okay, so we love pre-cuts here at Annabella's. Then what we did is we made up a bunch of Bella bundles for you, both, I believe these are minis. I think I made up 2 regular Bella bundles for those of you who want full fat quarters, and then I made up some minis. So let me show you what I have here. I may not show you all of these. Here is a mini Bella bundle, okay? So this is the mini, and look it. These mini Bella bundles are fantastic. I just showed you a lot of cross-stitch finishing that Wanda did. She doesn't use fat quarters, you guys, so I'm not gonna charge you for a fat quarter when you don't need a fat quarter. I'm gonna make these mini Bella bundles available to you so that you can pick and choose. Now, if you like to sew, you like to quilt, and you know you're gonna use the leftover fabric for one of your projects, then by all means, get the fat quarter bundle or buy the pre-cuts. But here is the mini Bella bundle the Georgia collection. It's called number 1. So when you're searching for this, you can type in Georgia mini Bella bundle number 1. Look how tiny these prints are. These are great for cross-stitch finishing. They will not take away from your finished design. They're just adorable. So that is the first one. I wanted you to see these tiny prints. Then the next one is... let me show you a big Bella bundle. This is a mini, this is a mini, this is a mini. Oh, they're all minis. Okay, let me show you this one as another tiny print. This is pretty too. They're also pretty. It's very hard not to want to take all this stuff home. This is really pretty. These colors are beautiful. Okay. This is another mini. This one is called Georgia. Mini tiny prints number 3. Tiny prints number 3. And these are raw supplies last. We do not reorder Bella bundles. I don't want to carry all that fabric. Too much, too much, too much. Okay, let me show you one of the larger prints. Now, this is also a mini Bella bundle, but the prints are larger, but they're not gigantic. So this again is, you know, you're able to use this for finishing in a number of ways, particularly if you're making a pillow. These are gorgeous. And this one is called Georgia Mini Number 1. Colors are stunning. That's Georgia Mini Number 1. I'm not gonna show you the rest. There's only 2 more, but I'm not gonna show them to you because I don't wanna take up too much of your time. So feel free to just search for Georgia in the Etsy shop and all of these will come up. You can pick and choose which ones you like. Okay, and again, the pre-cuts, amazing, right? And if you're not aware, we sell hundreds of cross-stitch quilt patterns. So if you see something that you love, you see, you know, a layer cake, or you see a jelly roll and you're like, what in the world? I want that fabric. I don't know what to make from it. Check out our patterns. You'll find something there. And if there's a designer, quilt designer whose patterns you love and you don't see them in the shop, please do email me and let me know. We want to carry what you guys love. There's so many beautiful quilt designers, you know, just as there are cross-stitch designers. We can't carry everyone, but if a few of you have a particular designer that we're not carrying, I'll be happy to add them to the shop. Okay. All right, next I'm going to show you this cute little stuff here because it's adorable. I couldn't wait for this to come in. This collection is by Gracie Larson. It's called Clover Farm. I'm going to show you two of the patterns that came in. Then I'm going to show you three bundles I put together for you. One is, we have both fat quarters and we have minis. So let me show you that in a second. Okay, so here is her stinking cute Clover Farm row quilt. Look at the chickens and the flowers and the bees. So adorable. Okay, and then this one is Reading in the Sunshine. So these quilt patterns are available. Back tells you exactly what fabric you need. Now let me show them to you. There's three colorways, mint, white, and yellow. So I'm gonna start with the yellow because it's my favorite. Look. Now, this is a fat quarter bundle I'm showing you, but the minis include the same. So you're gonna get in this one, 9 fat quarters or 9 fat eighths. All right, show it to you this way. So you can see all the pretties. I don't know if my fingers are that big. So this is yellow. You can see the tiny bees. There's the chickens. Pretty gingham. And I'll show them to you this way. They're just too cute not to show you. I love these tiny bees. Look at the chickens. This one's really pretty. Okay. There you go. Everything coordinates very nicely. Okay, so 9 there. Then we have, that's a yellow. Let me show you the white, or the mint. The mint is also really pretty. So you have your chicken. Look at the strings hanging off. I always tell my team not to have that happen. I'm gonna have to yell at her. She doesn't like when I yell. I don't yell very often, but really, honestly. Ugh, okay, whatever. The joys of running a shop, right? Okay, chickens. Cheater fabric. Pretty, huh? Look at this, so pretty. This kind of reminds me of Lily Pulitzer. Living in South Florida, she was big. I mean, she's a great clothing designer, but you've never seen so many women walk around in pink and green in your life. There you go. All right. So if you're looking for the mini or for the fat quarter bundle, you're going to type in mint, Clover Farm mint, and these will come up. And then last that I'm going to show you is the white. The pen. Did I not have this? I hope I didn't drop the pen because Chloe would eat it. Okay. This is white. Doesn't look all white to me, but that's what they're calling it. So there you go. You know, I think I got them confused. I think that was white that I just showed you. And then I think this one's mint. This is mint. Like that. It's so pretty. Again, lots of tiny flowers. Pretty greens. These are not duplicates of the white that I just showed you. These are totally different. Look at this one. I love this. It is definitely a mint. This is definitely mint. There you go. All right. All right, so there's that. So you've seen all of the Clover Farm fabrics that we have in the shop. I did not get pre-cuts on this. I decided not to carry them. Now what I'm gonna show you, because she's so incredibly popular here at Annabella's and we absolutely adore her, is the brand new Hometown Holiday Collection by Lori Holt. So if you are a Lori Holt fan, like I know many of you are, as I am, you're gonna love Hometown Holiday. So let me get another sip of coffee and then we'll move into that. We're at an hour, I'm ready to have a nervous breakdown. I never go this long. Please tell me if you hate going this long because I feel so guilty when I do. Good Lord, there's a lot of Bella bundles here, plus some other stuff. The problem, it's not a problem, is she's got so many beautiful fabrics in these collections. Okay, Hometown Holiday is gorgeous. The back of this go slow, you can see all of the fabrics in this entire collection. Now, Elaine does have a large store, but I think there's 44 fabrics. That's 44 bolts. So no, I'm carrying pre-cuts because I don't have room for 44 bolts. So pre-cuts are popular. You can grab a layer cake, you can grab a jelly roll, you can grab a charm pack, and your options are endless, endless. If you need backing fabric because you did do a charm pack or you did do a layer cake or you did do a jelly roll, backing fabric is widely available by the yard, by the half yard, at some of my favorite competitors that are also friends. So you can shop at any other quilt store if perhaps you want to get the fabric by the yard. We do carry a lot of fabric by the yard, you guys, but I can't carry every single collection. So this year we're not carrying 40 something odd bolts. It's too much. Okay, so what we did do though is we did put together some Bella bundles. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 Bella bundles in the Lori Holt collection. I am not gonna go through all of these. I'm gonna go through some of these and then I'm gonna refer you to the Etsy shop for the others. The first one I'm going to show you, because it's not bagged, is called Latte. Now, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There are 10 fat quarters in this bundle. It's the most pricey bundle that we have because it has 10 fat quarters. And we rarely put 10 fat quarter bundles together because it's a lot, right? And I'm trying to keep things affordable for you. But Lori rarely comes out with Latte. So I figured, you know what? They're gonna want it. So let me put it all together. So let me show you these prints so that you can see how adorable they are, or pretty is a better word. So you're gonna get all of these fat quarters in your Bella bundle. Now I'm gonna open this one up a little bit so you can see the words. So this is all Christmas themed, Christmas colors. And all of the Bella bundles in the shop, the mini Bella bundles that you see, are all going to have this fabric in it, this Christmas fabric. Okay, so here's this one, this one, this. Tiny little dots. I'm going too fast. I know you're going to let me know. I'll slow down. And then here is one that I just love. This is Christmas carols. So again, you're going to see the Christmas carols. See how pretty that is? All right. So that is called Hometown Holiday Latte. And that is the Latte Bella Bundle. Then, oh, I forgot to show you her needle minder. Look at him. He's so cute. So this needle minder is part of her Hometown Holiday collection. That is the snowman that's so popular right now. Everybody is either doing the quilt snowman or they're doing the cross-stitch snowman. Quilted snowman cross-stitch and quilted snowman quilt. But there, if you're stitching, this is a great needle minder. Beautiful gift, great stocking stuffer. Okay, now I'm gonna show you a couple of bundles that I love. This one is Schoolhouse. So there's two names that you'll search for when you're looking for the Hometown Holiday Bella bundles. You're gonna search for Hometown Holiday Schoolhouse, or you're gonna search for Hometown Holiday Basil. Or Hometown Holiday Latte, just those three colorways. This one is called Schoolhouse Number 1. Now, I want you to see the fabric, how pretty it is, and the church. Isn't that pretty? Then here is the Christmas carols. Little prints. See how pretty they all go together? This red is stunning. Then you have these pretty little flowers. I'm not gonna be able to hold all these. And here's the reds. Oof. I have a big mouth. I don't know that I have big hands. Here's the green. Then you have yellows and blues. Oof. And then last, you have the brown. So that Bella bundle, this way. Oh, that way. There you go. And again, this is schoolhouse number one. There's a schoolhouse number two and a schoolhouse number three. Each of the colorways are a little bit different in each of them. Schoolhouse number three is blues and reds. And then schoolhouse number two are greens and pinks. So check those out if you'd like. I'm sure you will find something that you love if you love Lori. Now I'm going to show you Hometown Holiday Basil so you can see a little bit in the basil collection. There's three as well, so there's three Bella bundles. These fabric, the possibilities are endless. Isn't that pretty? Look at these blues. Here's your basil words. Gorgeous. So that's basil. And then we have, like I said, the aqua and the red Hometown Holiday Basil. And then we have, these are yellows and grays, I would say. This one's really nice. And that's a basil number one. Okay, pretty cool, huh? All right, now, I don't know if I want to do that today. I don't think I'm going to do this today. Okay, I'll give you a sneak peek of what's ahead for QuiltTube. Okay, now that I got my tripod back, which was missing in action, what we're going to do is we're going to do QuiltTube back on Wednesdays. Because Wednesday's QuiltTube, Thursday's Throwback Thursday, and we're going to be back to Throwback Thursday coming this week. So tune in on Wednesday for QuiltTube, tune in on Thursday for Throwback Thursday, and then tune in again on Friday for FlossTube. What I'm going to do on QuiltTube next week so that you can plan ahead and maybe save the date is we're going to review the brand new Moda catalog. This is brand new. There are some incredible, gorgeous designs in here. This is the July catalog. And then most of these will ship in the next January, February, March. Okay, so I'm going to show you that. Then what we're going to review is Lori Holt's brand new Americana collection. This is gorgeous. I'm going to show you all of the fabrics. We're going to go through all of the notions. You're going to get to see all of the options, and we're going to review all of the kits. So that's going to be on QuiltTube next week. And then I have some other cute things that I'm going to share with you then as well. It's very likely that I will also have a surprise announcement for you. So tune in next week to QuiltTube. I look forward to seeing you there. Now, let me ask you a question. First, let me do Happy Mail because the question I'm going to ask you pertains to quilting. Okay, here is Happy Mail. If you're new to my channel, every week we give away Happy Mail. What's Happy Mail? It's a surprise that comes in the mail in a pretty pink envelope from Annabella's, just as our way of saying not only thank you for watching, subscribing, and ringing the notification bell, but for commenting and leaving comments on questions that I pose. In order to win Happy Mail, you have to have a few things going for you. You've got to be over the age of 18 so I can ask for your mailing address. You do have to be a subscriber to the channel. You have to comment on the question posed specifically. And if I call your name, you need to send an email to annabellasshop@gmail.com. You must put Happy Mail in the subject line, and then you must tell us your YouTube handle and your name and address, okay? So last week's question was, when do you start stitching for fall and Christmas? So I love that everybody, not everybody, but I love that a great number of you do what I do. You just stitch whatever you love throughout the year. But many of you are just starting to stitch fall and Christmas. But if you want to see what everyone else is doing, just read the comments below. So this week's question, this week's winners are Pam Ward, 7676, Kim Cox, 1970, Alice Marsh, 1152, Corey Wood, 1052, Ruby Maxi, 4577, and Gigi, 4768. So get that email to me and we'll get your happy mail right out. Then this week's question is kind of twofold. So I'm trying to make a decision here. Do you prefer this, where I do cross stitch, quilting, paper crafting, whatever, all in one video, or do where I just tell you advance to the end because now I'm going to do quilting, you can leave now, or do you prefer that I completely do two separate videos on two separate days and the whole thing? I want to know. Okay, so please be honest with me. If you enjoy this, where I'm on for an hour and I cover everything that's going on at Annabella's, whether it's cross-stitch quilting, wool, applique, paper crafting, which is coming soon next week if I get the stuff done. That's going to be another fun announcement. Do you want it all together or do you want me to do all separate videos? Please let me know. So comment below. Tune in next week. Hopefully you'll win some happy mail. Until I do see you this week, because I haven't decided what I'm doing yet. I will see you this week on Wednesday for QuiltTube. I hope you have a wonderful weekend. I hope you get to do all the things you love with the people you love the most. So until I see you, be happy, be well, and most of all, be kind. See you later. Bye.